Bengaluru's Bellandur Lake's toxic fumes have again raised several questions which the civic bodies need to answer. As if toxic froth wasn't enough of a nightmare for the residents, the dried weeds and industrial waste in the lake which caught fire is making the surroundings polluted. Shreeja caught up with the Indian Institute of Sciences Professor T V Ramachandra on this issue. Take a look at what he had to say.
Lake has been receiving untreated sewage and industrial effluent over almost a decade now. And when the industrial effluent or the sewage gets into the water body, naturally the favorable condition for the fire is also there. When you take the sewage consists of nitrogen and phosphorus. That's an ideal ground for the mat to grow because the nutrients are available. Now there is a thick mat formation of the macrophytes in the lake, and above that people have dumped the solid waste which consists of plastic, etc. Now below the macrophyte layer there is a methane formation because of anaerobic condition. Now there is a ideal condition for the fire. Now somebody has littered that, naturally the dry matter started burning, plastic has burned. Fire to the grow in the size. That's where you saw the huge fire in the system. Now coming to me being the committee, we have submitted the report. The committee has submitted a report about 8 months back. I would say it is because of the governance, the kind of procedure involved is the delay for this one. As long as the fragmented governance is there and a will to do something for the system is lacking in the system, then only the blame game is there in the system.
So you just mentioned that the committee had submitted a report on Bellandur 8 months ago. Had the government heeded to the committee's report, do you think a disaster, the recent the lake going up in flames, could have been avoided?
Well, it would have happened. Okay, see, for example, the report what we have submitted has got the short term and a long term solution. In the short term solution, we said that the macrophyte has to be removed at regular interval and we need to install the fountains so that because of that the aeration happens. With the aeration, you see that the treatment happens in the system. When the treatment happens, the lake would be in some condition which doesn't allow the methane to generate in the system. We would have averted this situation had we planned and implemented the short term solution, which was only 6 months. The short-term solution should have been implemented in 6 months and long-term solution is over 18 months.
Okay. Recently, that is the Karnataka State Pollution Control Board Chairman Lakshman, he told in a response to media, he told that these reports by the expert committee has been taken seriously, which is completely a blatant lie. But what we also understand is that N.A. Harris, MLA, who inspected the spot, said the shampoo, in fact, which has been flowing from different apartments was the reason or the cause of the fire. What do you think about it? What are your comments on that?
Well, I pity the statement of shampoo. I do not know how people come up with this kind of a statement. I think the local citizens have to wake up and we should start demanding the solution than listening to these people who just talk, come to the TV and then talk about it. Now, when I look at the fire cause, it is more to do with the polluting the lake and because of that, the macrophyte cover, then the plastic dumping or the solid waste dumping and the methane generation. It has nothing to do with the shampoo. Even if it is a shampoo, you look at the 500 million liters of sewage getting into Bellandur Lake from the city, whereas the apartment dwellers is only 20 or 30 MLD, apartment dwellers share. So that wouldn't have caused the thing. And scientifically, I don't agree with that irresponsible statement.
You can watch live TV on our website, mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.